So, hello, ladies and gentlemen, everyone. Thank you for joining us on UGC Monday Highlander. I am Kip, and today we are bringing you the silver match between the Last Bosses and Chain Reaction. Syndicate versus Bonus can be found on our sister channel, is XTV Esports 2, and that will be casted by Mustard Overlord and a friend. I don't remember who. So definitely check out that. You can flip between casts if you want. There will be VODs up later, too, so feel free to jump in and out of the cast. But while I'm still talking, I have a friend here with me to help me cast Yellowstone. Would you like to say hello?
Hey, guys. Ready for some silver?
I'm very ready for some silver. So Yellowstone, why don't you just introduce yourself real quick, because you're not my usual caster. Sud has... was not able to do it tonight, so I had to bring in backup. So Yellowstone, what's up?
Not much. I actually do play for a silver team, Retro Gamers. So I have actually scrimmed with one of the teams in the match today. Very cool guys. Haven't actually had a chance to scrim Chain Reaction yet, but everything that everyone says about them is they're very good. So this is probably two of the best teams in silver right now, or at least top four or five. So it's, 5 weeks in, you're starting to see kind of like very even matchups from UGC, and this is going to be a good one.
Yeah, absolutely. And right off the bat, I apologize for the camera work. I haven't streamed XTV before, and it's not high definition. That's another thing I apologize for. So it'll be a fun cast, though, I promise. Yellowstone and I like to have fun. And it's Swiftwater. How can you not love Swiftwater? How much do you love Swiftwater, Yellowstone?
Played a lot of NG on this map, and you can do so many different things with it. Like, it's so much better than last week, where you played Turbine if you were an NG, and you just sat there banging your wrench into the wall. It's really nice. I like it.
Yeah, I gotta say, I love playing NG on Switchwater, because there's always a lot of action, and you can be really creative with your spots, too. I'm really looking forward to it today. I'll go over our rosters when everybody said it's not to be Soldier. But I'm pretty sure Spamfest is the engineer for Chain Reaction, and he's an excellent engineer. Also, eager to see what Crow does for the Last Bosses. And he's a new engineer, and he was a little bit nervous about tonight. So we'll see what he brings in terms of sentry positioning and all that fun stuff.
And there are some pretty standard spots if you're going to run level 3s on this map. But if you're going to run minis, which is a pretty viable choice, even on defense, there's a lot of flexibility with how you want to play it, because you basically just pick a zone with your team, and you kind of lock it down with your mini sentries. So if you want to, kind of get creative about how you play your defense, there's really a lot of options for an engineer on this map.
Yeah, and then just watching the pregame pump up Chain Reaction, just banging soldiers. Anyway, you can see it. But also a lot of opportunity for creativity on offense. Many engineers tend to run the mini sentry on offense, but there's a lot of potential for a ring or a big level 3 sentry in offense, and using that to help your team gain ground. So, should be fun, for NGs at least.
I mean, as long as they can survive the, enormity that is Swiftwater and 5 control points worth of payload.
We'll see how it goes. Now, interesting stuff about this team. I got a pregame write-up with a lot of great information, and I will share that with you. I have to get out of spawn, though, because these soldiers are so loud. But, Chain Reaction. Both of these teams are undefeated, so they're both 4-0. Interesting factoid about Chain Reaction. They have only allowed 1 point to be capped in all 4 games. That includes King of the Hill, that includes Capture the Flag, and everything.
That is impressive.
It is really impressive. Now, some people say it is because they've had an easy schedule for these first couple of matches, but I mean, that's just crazy that they can hold off like that. So, should be really exciting to see what they bring. But the strategy, their team strategy is just premium. They really know how to work together as a team, and should bring a lot of effort and challenge to this match for the Last Bosses, who are not necessarily the greatest strategical team.
Strategical?
Did I just say that? Oh. Okay. But
it's okay. English isn't anyone's strong suit.
But Last Bosses, they are known to pretty much show up on Monday nights and play the first time together on that map. I believe right now they are going over strategy for Swiftwater, and that's why they're not in the server.
Well, they could be a while because this is a big map. If you
Yeah.
guys have any questions, I'm kind of keeping up with the chat, so I'll try and, be relevant.
All right. That sounds like a plan. So another thing I have heard, the last bosses, of course they're 4-0, and so if they don't have that strategy, then that means they're good at something else. And what is that going to be? That is going to be deathmatch skills. They have a lot of really solid players, a solid aim and deathmatch and all that type of stuff. So that is really where their strength lies. And that's not necessarily the same with Chain Reaction. So what the Last Bosses is going to try to do is really force Chain Reaction into those deathmatch situations where they think they have that upper ground. Now, if you were on Last Bosses and you did have this really strong DM, how would you try to force Chain Reaction into those types of situations?
I think for them the key is going to be if you have like a bunch of people grouped up, then your DM isn't going to be nearly as important as if you're in like a 1v1 or a 2v2 or something like that. So just kind of catching people off, like straggling off on the flanks, and then kind of using that player advantage to, maybe start a push. So I think, didn't you cast the Last Bosses game?
I have. I've casted them a couple of times, and very good. They like to have fun, and I've been told they didn't drink as much before this cast that they did their other game. So they should be pretty
Oh.
serious about this one.
Oh wait, how can that be more fun if there's less drinking?
Oh, you know what? That is a good point. I will have to ask them. But they're taking this really seriously. They're really excited to be casted, and so it should be really good. I'm really excited. These are the last two undefeated teams in silver right now, so a lot riding on this, at least pride-wise.
I mean, they seed the UGC playoffs with, like 16 teams. So if you're not like undefeated right now, you still have a great shot at making that upper playoff in silver and, competing for first place. So it's not a huge deal that you have a couple of teams that are 3-1, but I mean, being that top team means you're going to keep drawing difficult matchups, and that's going to stretch you as a team. And I think that experience of having to play, really good teams on a consistent basis will help your coordination and your cohesion when those playoffs do come.
Yeah, absolutely. I can't get over this pregame ritual of everyone going soldier and then taunting with the market gardener. It amuses me so much. But anyway, have some more interesting tidbits, I think. Let's see. Just going through my roster. Things to watch out for. Paragon is a beastly sniper. So we're gonna watch his cam a lot, hopefully, because Swiftwater can be so play so well into a good sniper's forte. And Yellowstone, what is your has been your experience playing against a really good sniper on a map like Swiftwater?
Oh, it's. I like I said, I've played a fair bit of NG because I'm like a all-class backup for my team. Between my real life and other stuff, I don't have a ton of time to commit to being a starter. So I play a lot of NG on this map, and man, you're like you got your sentry, you're so happy, you've got it up to level 3, and then you get sniped, and then some freaking scout just takes down your sentry while you're dead. It's so sad. You work so hard with level 3s, and that's why I almost enjoy running minis, even when it's probably not the best choice, because then I don't feel bad when someone kills my sentry.
There you go. And so Last Bosses obviously know their competition right here. They know Paragon is a great sniper, so it'd be interesting to see who they put as opposing sniper. I heard the rumors they may move Jumper, who is their usual scout, to sniper. So beware of roster changes. I also heard that somebody busted his shoulder for, oh, Keith Stone, the soldier for
We have a
Last
red
Bosses.
soldier in the circle now.
Uh-oh.
It's pretty great. There's a circle of blue soldiers all yelling at him, and he's just like, I'm totally gonna yell right back at you. I've got a bigger hat than everyone else.
This is amazing. This is why we do what we do.
Yeah, I'd say I'm a huge fan of that hat.
That's pretty nice. Apparently these teams are really good friends. They scrim together a lot and often ring for each other's teams. So looking forward to a really friendly match. So that'll be nice. But right now we gotta get everybody in here. Where is the last bosses?
Crow is here, so hopefully that's the beginning of a trend and we'll start seeing more people join up.
And of course he is confusingly
So what's your
up.
Feeling on the soldier beard? Are you a fan of the beard on the soldiers?
I think I'm a fan of a beard on everyone except my boyfriend. I do like it, yes. I like it paired with the Santa hat. I feel like on the soldier it is especially effective. I feel like it needs to be dyed though. I am loving the pink beard on Panda.
That's the reason I asked you, because I wanted to ask you what you thought of Panda's look. I'm a big fan of that pink beard.
It's unique, and he's got the weird skull thing, so he's intimidating. I love it. Very, very fond of it. Do we see any unusuals? No unusuals yet. So we will see who wins the hat contest.
You have to remember, though, that only one of these guys is probably on their main class, maybe two of them. Most of the rest of them are, you know, just kind of trolling with Soldier right now, so they may have an unusual, but it may be for their other classes. So.
Well, I hope so, because I can't cast a match if there are no unusual hats.
Wow. Word to the wise there, guys. If you want Kip to cast your match, you're going to have to plunk down and get an unusual.
Well, you got to realize, I'm normally with Sud, and Sud is such a hat trader, and he has like two unusuals for every class, so usually hats is pretty much what we talk about, but... Tonight it may not be.
I'm sorry to inform you guys, but your normal Monday has been co-opted. We might actually mention some TF2. There will be plenty of hat discussion, because I do love my hats.
Oh, we'll try not to do too much TF2. Don't want to get in there. And for those of you just joining us, welcome. This is Kip here with you with guest caster Yellowstone, making his XTV debut. And if you're curious, the bonus versus the syndicate match is on twitch.tv/XTVEsports2. So we're bringing you double UGC Highlander coverage today.
And they actually just went live.
They did, so there you go. Feel free to jump back and forth, though. Casting that will be Mustard Overlord and...
Yeah, so they've got actually more players in their server than we do. They've got... Oh, they're only missing one. We're missing a whole team. Oh, well.
Looks like we're finally filling up here a little. Sorry, learning the map has just joined the game, so I think that that tells you what they've been doing in this off time. If they manage to learn Swiftwater in 15 minutes, I'm going to be very impressed.
That would be quite the feat. I mean, this is an enormous map, and you could easily see someone get a, like, 15, 16-minute time and be like, yeah, we can defend that. And they're not being ridiculous, like... So huge. It's 5 capture points, some of which... I mean, the first point goes pretty fast.
Yeah, first point most people usually will give up.
I mean, it's like, you know, if you got a minute on the first point, you actually did a pretty good job on defense there, because the fastest you can cap it is, like, I think 42 seconds or something like that. So... If you got a minute, that's, you know, a nice 20 seconds, and that matters. But generally, you know, the first point goes by pretty quickly, but the second point here can be defended for quite a while. And then, of course, there's that enormous hill on the fourth point.
Yes, let's see. And we'll just be glad that in this version they took out the feature where it rolls back if you don't touch it.
That is true. I did play one of the older versions where they have two hills here, and the first one used to have a rollback, and now it thankfully doesn't. The second hill, though, still kind of does, but it's not quite as rough to get up that hill.
No, usually by the time you're there, you have already taken over the field and have pretty much pushed your enemy back, so you can push that up usually pretty fast. Wow, words are not working today.
Is there any way you can update the name on the channel page? Because people are confused as to why I'm not Sud, and I am too.
I wish I had that power, but unfortunately I do not, and the people who do have that power are currently in their own UGC game, so you're going to have to deal with it.
I want to be Sud, guys, I really do, because he has just like the best collection of hats, and I'm super jealous. You guys should ask Sud about his hats next time he's on. You could actually do that for pregame. Just have do like a fashion show.
You would love it. Oh, I see our first unusual Columbia Angmar. Oh man, these names.
Look at them. They actually, a couple got off of Soldier here. They're not going to just, their pregame ritual has ended. I'm so sad.
This is sad, but it looks like we have 9v9, so we hopefully will be starting shortly. Again, thanks so much for joining us tonight on UGC, or XTV's coverage
Monday.
Of UGC Highlander. There we go. And looking at the roster for the last bosses right now, they are in red. Let's see. So Cosine, for their soldier, is new tonight because their regular soldier, Keystone, hurt his shoulder in a snowboarding accident. I don't know where he was snowboarding in October, but that happened. So we will have Cosine as soldier. Multiple aides on demo. That is actually X, who is an excellent...
He's a fantastic demo man.
Yeah. I was told to mention this. He right now leads the ESCA in frags per minute. And he is above Banny with that title. So we're going to be watching...
High praise.
Yeah, we're going to be watching some of his cam. Alright, and then we have ZFX on Medic. Applesauce is Sniper. Raging Caucasian is Spy. Crow is Engineer. Sorry, Learning Map is Demo.
Someone in the server has a bind about you.
You know, yeah, I get that sometimes.
Did you really want to strangle kittens?
I would never strangle a kitten. I'm just going to go on record right now saying I would never strangle a kitten.
Because Jumper seems to think otherwise.
That is...
Just blasphemy?
Yeah, that's unacceptable. That's, what's it? When, somebody says words that you didn't say, it's legal term. Anyway, finishing up on the rosters real quick, we have Jumper on Scout, Ropern is Pyro. So... Scholar actually, they are now changing their names, of course, and tagging up, so we probably should have waited to do the roster, but Scholar will be Heavy. And I think that pretty much sums up the last boss's roster. Over on Chain Reaction, we still have six soldiers, so we're just gonna wait.
These guys love you. Right as you start to do the rosters, they start changing their names.
Oh my goodness, being a caster is so much fun. Alright, so, any other thoughts about Swiftwater? Let's look at this first point, actually. What I've been seeing, I've casted a couple of these matches so far, that pretty much teams are giving up the first point, which I don't agree with. I think you should build your sentry there and put up a good fight. But, what's your opinion on that, Yellowstone?
So my thought on the first point goes that as long as your NG can survive and have enough time to build at second, then you can D first. But if you can't get him out of there and you can't get your medic out of there, then I don't think it's worth it. Because you can actually hold for a very long time on the second point if you have, as long as you're not at a big uber disadvantage and as long as you have a level 3, you can hold second for a long time. So, provided you can keep your NG up and you don't lose your medic, then yeah, by all means defend first. But that can be really hard, just given the structure here, to get your NG and your medic out, because there's a nice sniper line out of spawn that covers that little bridge. And so you really don't want to be walking past it if you know the enemy sniper is up.
Alright, well, looks like we are finally going live, only 24 minutes late, but whatever.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, that's not bad, actually. I've waited much longer. So I'm trying to get on the Crow cam, see what kind of setup he's going for, because where the NG build is, like we said, going to define how they start this first hold, and it looks like Crow is going for an aggressive build. He is rocking the Eureka effect, which I like, so he may actually... build, and then once he's in danger, teleport back to spawn. It looks like we have a pause already, though.
Yeah, that's not a good sign. Although we do have some unusuals, so we are okay to cast this game.
We are
Colombian,
indeed.
Colombian, I think, has got the most ridiculous setup right now.
Who's that? Sorry, I didn't catch it.
A Colombian Gamer. We're gonna go with Colombian Gamer. All right. I
10 seconds.
Unfortunately, this does not bode well for our cast that we haven't even gotten out of setup time with a pause.
Well, of course, we are on the STV, so we're about 2 minutes delayed. That means this pause will happen 2 minutes in the future of this game, or 90 seconds, or something that's really confusing. I don't quite understand it. There's time travel involved, I've been told.
There is. It's exciting.
Yeah, and you have to be careful not to kill yourself or kill your parents, I believe. You cease to exist in the STV or something.
Well, then your respawn timer would just be enormous, and that would just be boring.
This is true. Alright, so yeah, Colombian Gamer has three effects going on right here. That's just ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous.
It really is. Like, he's going overboard. I guess he heard what you said, that you weren't going to cast the game if there weren't some unusuals, and he had to get right on that.
Alright, well, props to that. Somebody asked in chat, who is predicted to win this? And that is an excellent question. Right now, it would seem to favor Chain Reaction, because they have superior strategy and team skills, and they've practiced more. But if the last bosses can pull out their strategy of just forcing Chain Reaction into DM, I think the last boss's superior DM skills will win out. I think a lot has to do on the sniper battle. We'll see if Applesauce can shut down Paragon, which will definitely be a task in itself.
And there are so many good sniper lines on this map, especially on that like really important fourth point where you can hold for so long. It's this enormous open area, and there's just so many places for the sniper.
Yeah, and of course, on this first first point, one of the popular places for a sniper is Shifty's Quick Shot, a nice place to grab a drink after the game.
UGC actually, can't remember who it is, but someone made a nice prediction website where everyone can kind of post their predictions, and I just went and looked it up, and it's a 20-12 for Chain Reaction, so not an even split, but pretty close. So there's not a consensus on who's better here. I think both these teams are pretty evenly matched, although a lot will probably depend on how much preparation the last bosses actually did, and if they know the map.
And we will see. Looks like we just had that quick unpause so the player can rejoin. So we'll probably be going live pretty soon. I'm going to keep an eye on Crow. Again, I don't want to put too much pressure on him, but this is about his fifth game playing engineer in an official match. So we'll see how he does with probably one of the most difficult engineer maps.
The ice skating is certainly going to make things more enjoyable.
Yes, and I apologize already because the HUD is going to be outdated. It does not refresh, and even if I try to reload a HUD scheme, it does not work. So just you can deal with it for a little bit, hopefully.
We're very sorry about it, guys. It will fix itself. You just have to be patient.
Very interesting spot for Crow to build right here. Do you see this essentially gone right behind this board?
This general area is pretty common, but it's not always behind the board. Oh, huge air shot by the red soldier as we actually get open the gates here. And the blue demo and blue soldier are going to jump in. And oh, did Paragon just air shot him out of the sky? I think he did.
Oh, my. But we saw that Sentrygun actually denied the jumper right there. Crow going down immediately, so that Sentrygun has no chance. Uber is popped for blue as they're pushing up through the creek. Last bosses is pretty much scattered and designed.
And the spy's all over him! Oh! He gets the heavy, but he misses the medic, so red spy there. He was just waiting for that Uber to finish. The Raging Caucasian does get the heavy, but they're gonna cap this point, so. Is that another pause?
Oh my. Oh my.
We are on a roll, guys.
Alright. So, we could talk about that first push. What we saw was a pretty normal setup. We had both soldiers over here defending this, or trying to get control of the left house, which is a very key play because then you can have easier access to the tunnel right there. Blue got control of that pretty quickly, and that kind of dictated the rest of this first point for them.
Yeah, Crow Sentry actually did some good work there. The blue soldier and the blue demo took a really big jump in, either trying to get a force on the red medic there, but the Sentry actually did a good job of kind of pushing them back and really messing up their aim. And so in that regard, it was good sentry location because it helped deny jumpers and it gave his medic a little bit of breathing room. But, no one really expects to hold on this point for very long, and so it shouldn't really be a surprise that they captured the first point.
So what we'll be on the lookout for is where Crow decides to build at this second point then, which is a lot easier to defend. As you say, there's lots of good sniper lines, there's a full ammo pack too, so we'll see how he decides to do with that.
I mean, the Red did get their medic out. Doesn't have a name, unfortunately.
ZFX, I believe, is the medic's name.
ZFX. So he got out, which is, good play from him. They lost their demo, they lost their heavy, but they did get Crow out, and they did get their medic out. So in that regard, like I was saying at the beginning of the game, I think that's a good trade for them. They bought probably 20, 25 seconds there on the first point, which is really all you can hope to get, short of, just steamrolling people. Although the blue soldier is kind of trying to get forward here. He's got a pyro to deal with, but he is pretty close to this red medic, so ZFX might have to watch his back. Oh, they go.
And here we go. Panda
Good
in on the
reflex though from
tumble.
Panda.
Yeah, doing some damage right there, but he's not going to follow up and take it. We actually have somebody camping the tunnel with some stickies. But Blue being very aggressive, already taking control of the tunnel, which is going to be huge.
Oh, he gets the soldier.
Oh,
Sticky camp
Deadbolt.
on the teleporter. He gets him.
So it
Great
worked
play.
out there for him. I realize we haven't gone over the chain reaction roster, but we will do that presently when we get a lull. But right now, chain reaction is doing a great job of just rolling this cart as fast as they can. Deadbolt is
Oh,
up.
spy on the sentry. Oh, he gets the sentry. So Crow was momentarily distracted there, and the blue spy came in and got the sentry there. So nice job from Colombian Gamer. And now the demo is going to spam out his second sentry, and this does not look good for TLB.
Yeah, they
and
just don't have control of the situation at all right now. They need to lock down the field, but they're just not going to be able to do it. Blue is pushing way too fast, way too furious. Vengeance would be very proud. They also have an upper ground here and sending a lot of rockets that spammed out his Panda, the soldier. And there we
But a
go.
nice play from the red combo here. They waited in the back of the second point, and they waited for them to cap, and then the door opened up, and they were able to escape out with, it's 80% Uber. Oh, my HUD is broken. They were able to escape with their Uber, and Crow has actually got another level 1 sentry up on this roof here, so they should be able to defend third here.
We do have 100% Uber from Chain Reaction, but being challenged right now. Force Pop X was in the house there, doing a great job forcing that pop, but it's not going to be too much because we will still be able to get out here.
Oh, this is looking bad for Red. Yeah, Blue is already going to cap, and I mean, that was almost no defense there. They had that Uber Vange, and they got the sentry before it could even, do anything. And now there's no defense set up on the fourth point. Blue is already pushing forward.
Yeah, Chain Reaction is just rolling them right now. 2 minutes and 25 seconds for the first 3 points, and it's pretty ridiculous.
This may not be as long a cast as we thought, viewers, if they just keeps up. Oh, Blue Soldier tries to go in for the red medic. But, oh, he gets taken down, sniped. So Paragon used the soldier distraction to take down ZFX. So no Uber for Red here and no sentry. This is going to be another point that they're going to have real trouble defending.
You get Cosine in on the cart, but actually falling back to the garage right there. I'm not exactly sure what he's doing. So he is behind them if he could get a good medic right now. But actually, Saras is down. And quick shout out to Saras. Victoria, I think, is a lady gamer, so way to be. You go, girl. Is, I believe, the proper response to there. But anyway, here is the fourth point capped in 3 minutes and 28 seconds.
She's
Absolutely
gotta be
crazy.
real happy about that, because she went down, but the red medic was down. ZFX, he goes down again, I think. So, man, that has gotta be one of the fastest times I've ever seen on Swiftwater.
Right now, Crow has resorted to mini sentries because he just can't get anything up. And he.
Oh, it's sniped.
And here we go. They're just players up right now. No defensive engineer stuff. It's just going to be the heavy and medic right on the cart. So is Raging Confusion just going to stand on the cart as well? Oh, I'm sorry, that's applesauce right there.
And the blue Uber is in, and you see, oh man, they're gonna get that sentry, and they're actually forcing the red medic. He's on crits actually right now, and he's at 90%, so if he can survive this Uber, he might be able to push back, but blue's all over his cart. Oh, blue medic goes down. They're only two up now. Can the soldier get the cap? The medic is trying to defend. He gets an Uber Saw, actually. And he pops a Chris on the Pyro.
Wow.
Crazy exchange there. Oh, and the scout's all over the Pyro. Oh, medic and Pyro go down. The scout, if he can take the sniper, he'd actually get this cap tier. Oh, and he does get it. Great play there from the blue scout. Sadir?
Yeah.
Sadir.
We'll go with that.
He took down the Pyro with crits. Not, you know, pretty impressive. He took down the medic, and then he got in on the sniper before anyone could block him, and he just pushed the cart that last little bit there. And a 4 minute, 42 second capture time is just insane.
Yep, that is pretty ridiculous. The Last Bosses certainly have their work cut out for them. So for those of you just joining, this game just started, and Chain Reaction is up, or has set the time of 4 minutes, 42 seconds. So they're in a very nice position right now. They're gonna have to pull something out.
Mission begins.
Some sort of creative strategy if they want to challenge this time.
I mean, if we remember from that first half there, the only time the cart really stopped was for momentarily in that tunnel. Like, other than that, Blue pretty consistently, or Chain Reaction, who's now Red, they consistently push the cart at least, you know, one, sometimes even all the way up to 3x. And you're going to have to, you know, if you fail even one push here, Last Bosses are going to be in trouble.
Yeah, they're going to have that times 3 on the cart. And right now we're seeing Chain Reaction is actually going to go for the same type of build that Crow did, which is have the sentry gun behind this fence, and that will hopefully discourage jumpers.
But Blue Demo gets a big jump in and survives it, so maybe not quite as effective this time. The Red Medic did not pop, though. He was on fire, he got hit, but he got a sandwich from his heavy. I'm very sorry. She got a sandwich from her heavy there, and so she's going to hold on to this Uber, and you know, if they can get any defense on this first point, that's going to be huge for them, because the time is already so low. You see the blue medic running forward here. He's going to try and connect up with his demo. That sentry is still up, though, and that's just astounding. Blue Uber's actually popped, but the medic is stuck in the river, I guess we'll call it.
Yeah, and that Uber's going to do nothing from down there. The Last Bosses, though, were able to take advantage of that and do kill everyone but two, and now getting some respawns from the Last Bosses. So they are continuing this roll. They're not looking too bad, but they only had times one on the cart for a while, and they have to have that times three.
But Paragon got two snipes there, and that was just huge because he allowed his NG to set up this level three in the tunnel, and you know, Blue was looking, they had their demo, they had their heavy up, they were ready to push into this tunnel here and just kind of, you know, steamroll their way forward, but those two snipes there slowed them down. Oh, just as I say that, the medic gets backstabbed. So Colombian Gamer takes down the medic.
So with that, it looks like Last Bosses, I mean, they can't afford to be passive right now, so they're just going to continually be aggressive, but right now they just don't have the numbers to do it.
Paragon snipes Applesauce, so that's three in a row for him. He's on fire right now. He has been holding this door, just denying the Last Bosses, even though their medic is now finally back. But, I mean, that sniper play has just been huge to defend this narrow choke point.
On Colombian Gamers. Oh, and he gets the pick on Roper and then the engineer thing, but going for the medic right there. But did not get it, but ZFX medic went down anyway, so there we go.
Yeah, I mean, Blue is really having trouble pushing through this door. They don't have their medic. ZFX just respawned. And, I mean, that sentry isn't even covering the cart right now, but it doesn't matter because the red heavy is just being very aggressive at kind of denying people entrance. And Blue is on crits, actually. So ZFX switched off to crits when he died there.
We have 100%.
Can he survive? Oh, no, he goes down. So he gets piped down. Deadbolt actually pipes down ZFX, the blue medic there. So that switch up to crits, it's not going to work if you die.
No, definitely not going to work when the other team has this Uber, and Sarah's Victoria is just holding onto it, waiting for the right moment. Only about less than 2 minutes left for Chain Reaction to hold, and I don't think it's physically possible at this point to get to the end in less than 2 minutes.
I mean, showing from the defense that Chain Reaction is putting up here, they really have thought this out. You know, they have their team well spread out, they're covering the entrances, and, I mean, it just doesn't look like the Last Bosses were ready for this.
No, and I think after that first round, just where they got completely rolled, they didn't expect to win this round at all. So I actually saw Crow call it about a minute ago. He said GH, which is good half, already giving up. an interesting strategy. Crow has actually switched back to Pyro, and Ropeburn is now on Engineer. Those were actually their classes in Season 6 when they took first place in Steel Division. So back to more comfortable classes, and we'll see what Ropeburn can do then for his team as Engineer on Scrapwater.
Yeah, I think the Walsies are kind of coming out here. The Blue Soldier is on the direct hit, which, I mean, does have some uses, but he was on the rocket launcher for most of the game when it was serious. And Blue has stayed on crits, and they just get demolished by this Uber. The Uber Heavy just dropped right on top of the Medic, just took him down immediately.
And it looks like with only 40 seconds left, nobody on the cart, and we're going to call GG, or GH right here. Loves a sentry position by Spamfest. He's got a sentry just to the left of the tunnel exit, so hopefully it'll take people by surprise. And if last bosses were really competing to win right this round right here, it could be very disastrous.
But I think that's an important point, because for the next half, the last bosses are going to start out on offense, so if they've seen where he put the sentry, that'll help them out in their next half when they coordinate a push, because they are going to start out on offense, and they should be able to focus that sentry down, because it is kind of off in a corner there. It's meant to be sneaky, not necessarily get as much damage as like the normal spot above on this hill. Oh, now he's moved it onto the hill, so never mind.
He actually built a teleporter entrance right by the gun and then teleported to the hill. It was crazy. So we'll see what the second half brings, but so far we are up, or Chain Reaction is up 1-0. We're going to have a team switch real quick.
Very convincing round win there by Chain Reaction. That was very impressive on offense, and I mean, their defense was excellent, even independent of their time. Like, they held them at the door of this tunnel, and then once they got into the tunnel, it wasn't like they kept rolling through there. I mean, they did a great job on defense, independent of the fact that they set a 4:42 capture time.
Right. Just looking at the scores real quick, we see Deadbolt and Psydeer and Zorf as Pyro all above the Medic right now for Chain Reaction. That means that they have been super offensive, having the demo, the high damage class, and then Pyro, which is very unusual to be high scoring in Highlander, and then Psydeer, of course, Scout, you're going to be on the card a lot. That makes sense, but that means he's also been doing great work in defense. So, interesting classes to be first in points right there.
Yeah, I mean, Deadbolt has been leading these pushes from Chain Reaction, and he's been putting out a ton of damage, and that's really just allowed so much room for his other classes to kind of, like, clean up. I mean, the Pyro has been coming in on the flank to kind of clean up all that damage coming out of his grenade launcher.
Yeah, and then looking over on the last bosses who are on red right now, we have Raging Caucasian, the Spy, as leading in points. That's not unusual on Swiftwater. But
he does get double points for backstab, so.
This is true. Which is cheating.
Now, I'm not accusing him of, you know, point hacking or anything like that, because you also get an extra half point for headshots, which is, you know, those take a lot of skill. Like, props to him there. But those scores can be a little deceiving for spies. And the second half is actually going to go live, so a nice short halftime there.
Thank goodness.
We appreciate it.
Oh, and scores are reset, so we'll see who brings it this round. I'm going to watch Spamfest's camera. And see what kind of defense he has going on. He only has about just two people suicided from him. I like to have at least three. But I think he's going to go for the setup he went for in the first round, which is that sentry behind the fence.
Mission begins in 30 seconds.
Yes, and as somebody pointed out in chat, we are on the spam cam.
It's an exciting place to be, although he has a slightly different... So, I mean, this is a different sentry location from the last round.
I think he is using that full ammo pack, and then he's going to move the sentry gun to behind the fence.
Mission begins.
At least I think that's what he did last time.
Yep, and you are correct. Yep, prophetic nature there, she calls it. But the sentry should be able to get built up to deny jumpers, and that's really the goal of that sentry location. You see the red soldier... Oh, huge jump by the blue demo man. Yeah, and that sentry immediately focuses him. So, sentry doing its job.
Yeah, he's trying to get something started right there with the medic. And actually, Sarah's Victoria did go down right there. I didn't even see. What happened? Do you see her drop?
Oh, she got bombed.
Oh, that was X's. That was X's bomb. All right. So successful in that push, that's going to buy a great Uber advantage for the last bosses, and that's really something they need to hold on to and utilize if they're going to put up a fast time. Right now they're behind in Psyche as they are in points. Blue Uber popped way out of position. I think ZFX was forced there, so not the proper use of the Uber that they wanted, but they are pretty quickly capping this first point, taking a lot of space, and gonna be able to do this very easily, it looks like.
I think we have a pause.
Of course we do.
So, we see that the last bosses have, you know, easily kept first here. It took them a little bit longer, but they did not get the engineer, Spamfest, so he's got a level 1 sentry in this tunnel spot that really gave the last bosses so much trouble in the last round here. So, let's see if they can do a better job of cracking it this half.
Yeah, it looks like we had a ZFX medic for last bosses crash, and that's, of course, a class you need on Highlander. And just looking at pings, too, Ropeburn is playing with a 378 ping. I wonder where he is.
Well, we know ping to Brazil is about 200, and ping to Europe is also about 200, so I can only imagine where he is.
Antarctica?
Could be exciting.
That sounds pretty nice this time of year.
Yeah, it's the summer down there.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's Southern Hemisphere.
There you go, science.
Yeah. I have friends, I'm in physics, and they have a physics experiment down in Antarctica, so he goes down there every summer. It's the lovely and warm Antarctic summer of, I think he said, minus 10 Celsius.
Oh, jeez. We also have someone chat thinking he may be in Iceland, or the moon?
The moon, yes.
The moon, that absolutely makes no sense.
It does, yeah. People were speculating after that there was an intercontinental match this weekend, a Highlander match between the Syndicate and SNSD, a top European Highlander team, and they played it in New York, which is, the pings were relatively even, although SNSD definitely had kind of the worst share of it there, but people were saying that we just need to get a server and float it out into the middle of the Atlantic so that Europe and America can play TF2 with even pings.
That's what I'm saying. That's absolutely the proper response. And for those of you who have not checked out that show match between SNSD and the Syndicate, you have got to go to YouTube/VanillaTV and get those VODs, because it was really, really great match, and just great for the TF2 community, bringing together these top teams. And hopefully we'll be able to do something like more things like that in the future.
Yeah, I was watching the match. My team was in STV, and when we saw that first capture time on Badwar, I'm not going to spoil what happened, but it was very fast. Like, both teams, just unbelievable offense. And I should stop talking because we just went live again.
Well, there we go. So, we will see how this tunnel build holds up. There's only 4 up right now for Chain Reaction, so they'll definitely have their work cut out for them, as Blue is continuing to keep up the pressure, continuing to push. Looks like Red just got some respawns, and of course, sorry about the HUD not refreshing, but we'll deal with that as we go.
So we got to remember in about 90 seconds the blue medic is going to drop, and we really just hope it's not while he has full Uber, because that would just be really really disastrous for Blue, and that's not what you want to see. But we see Blue is actually going to bypass the tunnel completely. They're pushing all of their heavy classes up into this kind of, like, I don't know, apartment side here, and that's going to negate that sentry, and actually Red is only now just realized it, but their medic is just kind of sitting here with this sentry. And they're going to get flanked if they don't have someone jump up there. Oh, the soldier's on the blue medic! Oh, takes him down! Panda with a great job going up there, and he takes down ZFX. So, big play from Panda to cover that flank.
Oh, I missed that, but also X going down there too, so not having that demo man going to be key as well. So this tunnel hold, like you said, they just really bypassed it, don't really care, but at the same time, the cart has to go by that sentry gun at some point.
Yeah, I think the goal was to try and get in behind them and then use an Uber to kind of flush out the sentry from behind, but that doesn't work when your medic gets bombed by a soldier.
No, absolutely, you gotta watch out for that. Got to. And as we've seen, Panda has been a very good soldier so far, using the jumping opportunities that Swiftwater provides.
And Red has Uber here, and they're still holding this tunnel very effectively, and it looks like Blue has actually decided we're going to go right in their face. They're not trying to go back through this top side. They've got their medic here. Soldier goes in, but he's not going to have any luck without an Uber. That's just so choky in that tunnel. But here's where ZFX, I think, drops. Because he's just floating in midair, yeah.
Yeah, there we go. So, Nomad.
That's a real, I mean, he was at about 30% Uber there, I think, so it's not a huge loss there, but that means that they're going to have to wait another minute to push, and that's just, you know, going to add another minute to their time.
As we've seen, that Chain Reaction, being the really strong strategic team that they are, you can't afford, like, even 10 seconds is going to make or break the match or a game for you.
And we see Spamfest has kind of moved his sentry back a little bit. It's now kind of not quite as exposed in this tunnel, and he's using their players. Oh, and a red Uber has popped, actually a little bit on the spy as well, but mainly on this red demo man here. And this is just kind of clearing out some space. Can't really go for the medic pick because the medic wasn't in the game, but, you know, just kind of delaying the last bosses a little more.
Just that much harder right there. And as you said, the sentry gun, okay, I see.
Just moved it a little bit back, and so now we see Blue kind of taking a little bit of aggressive positioning in this tunnel. They still don't have Uber, but because the sentry was moved back, they have been able to take a little bit of space in here. But everyone is so clustered up here that it almost might be a good time for crits. And yeah,
you know what?
Blue is actually on crits, so I got something right.
I was
so
thinking,
happy.
He was charging real fast right there, so we'll see how that goes.
Loses his heavy and his demo, so he lost Scholar, he lost X, so he's going to get this crit, but he's not going to be able to use it for it, and as a consequence, Red is going to finish their Uber. So Seraph's Victoria has her Uber, and she's got her demo very aggressive at the front of this tunnel, but they're just peeking. This blue spy has been trying to get in here, but he just had no luck. There's so many people, so many stuff to bump into that he hasn't been able to have any space.
He gets the pick on ZFX, drops that crits right there, and that's probably going to prompt Red to come out and just use their Uber to, again, create more space and carve out more space for them.
And that's just a total function of the way these teams are positioned. You see that Red is clustered up, that makes it very hard for the spy to get in. But Blue, they're all watching this one door, and no one was watching this side flank up here, and the spy just came in, got in behind them, and backstabbed the medic.
Very unfortunate. They're definitely gave them another minute or so. Here we see the red pop. Popped on the demo man. Deadbolt comes in, tries to destroy everything he can. We'll see if he can't take out this heavy, but no heavy spun up, and now he is in the creek.
He looks like he might actually get away. Like, he took a huge... Oh, never mind.
Cosine
big
with the
jump by Cosine with the DH takes him down, but... he went for the medic there, but the medic just wisely hid behind this kind of sliding door here, and that really denied him any shot. So Red is actually down four players here. Now would be a good time for Blue to push. Oh! And they take down the medic, so Sarah's Victoria gets sniped by Applesauce here. Now is definitely the time to push, guys. They pop that crits on the heavy, and he runs out of ammo! And the sentry is somehow still up. Finally, they take it down, but that's just not what you want to see there. Your heavy runs out of ammo with crits, so a little bit of lack of communication there from the last bosses. I mean, they're going to take this tunnel, but Red is going to have a chance to rebuild some defense on the second point.
Absolutely, and that took way too long. Remember, the second point is right here. They still have to make it this, 20 feet in TF2 length to that second point, which is going to be so hard.
And I'm in the spy, again, trying to get in on the red medic, but that pyro has just been there to deny him. Whether it's the pyro or the Jurati, they've just been finding him out. He's had no luck getting on top of Sarah's Victoria. She's been safe and really hasn't had to worry about it at all. Blue crits popped again on the heavy this time, but he hasn't been able to get any good positioning. He can't even see the red heavy or the red medic. They're just hiding in this house here, and they're going to take some space in this yard. Blue combo actually is all over the point here, and they're going to get a cap, so the heavy's eating a sandwich, actually. Red soldier is all over, takes advantage of that sandwich. Oh! Medic goes down, so ZFX gets taken down by Panda there. He took advantage of the heavy eating the sandwich to kill the medic, so great timing there. And you see the red combo is still in this house.
Yeah.
Sarah's Victoria has Uber, so they can use that to get back to third, but they're kind of a little out of position now.
Oh.
Heavy on heavy.
Heavy coming
up
from behind, taking out the heavy, but Sarah's Victoria stayed alive, and she can pop it on Deadbolt, her demo, and doing a lot of damage right there, taking down Scholar, and then clearing off the cart, going to buy their engineer a little bit more time. He does have that level 3 sentry up, now he can get a dispenser and all that fun stuff going. Actually,
yeah, but
he's
we see Blue is still on the crit, so they're going to have this very soon. I mean, they may be able to get it before even like a level 2 sentry is up, because, oh, never mind. I say that he's been building like crazy.
I love
all
this.
On top of the silo.
Yeah, Spamfest built a teleporter there, then destroyed the teleporter entrance so our spy can't get to him. But some great stickies from
huge
X.
Stickies.
And
so
crits coming
crit.
In too.
They waited on the crits. They saved it until they got the sentry, because obviously crits doesn't do anything to the sentry. The red soldier here jumps in. Oh, he takes down ZFX again. So, man, huge props to Panda. He's gotten the blue medic twice now. I mean, they did get off their crits there, but they didn't get enough kills with it. It just took down the sentry. So red has actually got a solid defense being set back up. And you see Sarah's Victoria. She's got a 95% uber. They're going to hold this for at least another minute.
Yeah, and only about 3 minutes left for the last bosses to get that next point, which is probably one of the harder points. Oh, I'm sorry. They still have... The card is very close to that. But the point after this one is one of the hardest to get, so...
But it is moving backwards, and that's really just not... You'd expect to see someone kind of maybe, you know, run forward, just tap the card so it stops moving backwards, but the Blue Scout and the Blue Spy are kind of busy right now, and so this card is just kind of slowly inching backwards, and that's just more time that Blue has to spend pushing that card, and less time they can use to actually be getting frags.
I'm on the Columbia Gamer Cam right now. Oh, he had a really good position behind the medic, but somebody called him out, and there we go, not able to get any things from that.
And Panda tried to go in on the ZFX again, but this time Scholar was there and just shot him out of the sky. Oh, huge snipe. Applesauce just takes down Sader. I don't know how to say his name. I'm sorry, man. But the blue spy is in. Oh, he gets Spamfest, but he can't lay the sapper in, so that sentry is going to stay up, and the pyro doing a great job. Oh, never mind. The direct hit from Cosine comes in, so good teamwork there. And the crits is pop, but uber in response, so red looks like they have good positioning here. Heavy's crits is just going to bounce off those invulnerable players.
It's also really good strafing by ZFX. He managed to stay alive for a little bit, but then eventually went down. So that's going to be a failed push right there from the last bosses. And they can't afford too many more failed pushes.
They got their NG on the card here, though, so they've actually done a good job of pushing it forward. And if you can cap this, you get a new spawn for blue, and it's right here. It's right next to this red spawn. So if you can even sneaky cap it, it is huge.
Definitely going to have their work cut out for them, though, because it looks like Deadbolt putting a lot of stickies and down. We also have spun up heavy. This is not looking too great for the last bosses. They have less than a minute.
I mean, they'll get more time if they can capture this point, but a level 3 sentry has already been set up by Paragon, and he just teleported away, so not quite sure where he's going to put that sentry, but they really haven't got anybody even in. You'd expect to see, like, someone from red up here. Oh, the blue spy takes down the NG right as he's laying down his sentry, so no sentry for red here. This could be a little bit of an opening for blue. Red's going to have an uber advantage, but they will have time to build this and, you know, use uber to get this one final push.
They have to act fast, though. It looks like Sarah's Victoria has 100% uber, so she can at any time pop that to stop the cart. And will probably do so relatively soon, as there's only 16 seconds left. Blue making those final pushes. Blue med is up and really close to the spawn, trying to get that crits before it's gone. Sarah's Victoria pops, actually forced by the pyro right there.
Down. So Spamfest came in from behind and took down VFX, and there's no way they're going to cap without a medic or crits here. Oh,
well,
just as I say that, the blue soldier comes in. Oh, but he gets taken down.
Oh,
so,
wow.
Good PP there from the sniper, and then good stickies from Deadbolt. And there's still... Wow.
Yeah,
there we go.
That was a long overtime.
That was a very long overtime.
So then, because the last boss has failed to cap that second point, there are two ways that Chain Reaction can win. They either cap the first point in less time than it took the last bosses, or they just continue, or they cap that second point. Oh, and third point, sorry about that. That was probably really confusing. Let me try this again. There are two ways that the last bosses, or that Chain Reaction I'm failing at this. Yellowstone, you want to take it?
You want me to try it?
Please.
Alright, so if Chain Reaction can cap 3 points, they win. Straight up. Or they can cap 2 points faster than 7 minutes, 5 seconds. So if either one of those happens, they will win. So the timer is going to be a little bit deceptive because it's first going to go with that scenario where you cap 2 points in under 7 minutes. If that does not happen, then all they have to do is capture 3 points in total. So those are their two options. But judging by the offense that Chain Reaction showed us in the first round here, This is going to be a real tough hold for the last bosses.
Indeed, it looks like Crow is actually going for a sentry gun hold on the first one and taking down Panda as he jumped in trying to get that medic. So going to be successful right there. His medic is still alive. ZFX kind of out in the open, out of position right now, but going to stick with his combo. Spy in behind Red, so this could be very disastrous. Nobody has spotted him out yet. Here he comes for the medic.
Oh,
can he get the kill? Oh, wow.
He just missed the stab there. The medic turned right at the last second, and the sentry took him down. So.
Oh, no!
But
it doesn't matter, because Paragon got the pick anyway, so that's a drop. Sarah's Victoria is going to have 100% Uber and 100% advantage right there, and I think she's still on spawn. She was just waiting to come out. She's going to be safe right now, Sarah's Victoria, and continuing that this push is...
Oh yeah, they've got this, and they're not even going to have to use it, so they're going to have... Oh, the Uber does get forced there, so just as I was about to say, they could use it for a second, but the Uber does actually get forced, so it's going to be about an even Uber when they get out the second, but Red NG just started building a sentry right now, so it's going to be real rough for the defense. They have to hold for almost 6 minutes on this point, and they haven't even gotten a level one sentry up. And Red's on crits.
Interesting.
So ZFX is on crits here, and they realize that they've got to do something. They've got to change it up, because what they've been doing has not worked. They've just, you know, had a really hard time on defense here. I mean, the last round, Chain Reaction set a 4 minute, 42 second time for the whole map. So that's less than the time they need here to cap one more point. And the soldiers are doing a great job spamming the NG here, and they're going to get that level 3 sentry up, but they do get a couple of frags there, so... This blue heavy is kind of isolated underneath the sentry. He's waiting for his medic. They're at about 85% Uber, so as soon as they get this, Sarah's Victoria's going to try to...
Oh, here comes
crits! Comes in.
Oh, huge crits right there from X, taking down three, I think.
Ooh, and then Applesauce snipes Sarah's Victoria, so she tried to juke by going out the tunnel entrance, to kind of, and it did work on the demo, but she ran right into the sniper, so that's not going to work out.
So that guy's about another minute for the last bosses on defense. And the sentry gun did go down. I believe it was zapped right there. But Crow is busy and hard at work rebuilding that, so it'll probably be up relatively soon. He's got that full ammo pack right here. Meanwhile, Red is just trying to hold on as best they can.
So that was a great call to switch to that crits there. They got it about like 7 seconds before the enemy team, and they just knew they got called out. The blue combo was hiding in this little tunnel here. And I mean, the medic got out. Or kind of got away, but they were just too clumped up and they weren't ready for that crit. So great surprise play there from the last bosses.
Absolutely, and they're still on crits again. Looks like they're going to... They do have 100%, probably going to pop it on X again in the tunnel. They've spotted out the heavy meta combo, taking down Deadbolt and the heavy right there. I think the...
ZFX, Sarah's Victoria looked like she just lagged there because
yeah.
She just stood perfectly still. So... I think players have been having trouble the whole game. We've had, like, what, four pauses, I think, or three pauses?
Yeah.
So, I hope it's not actually dropping out, and it's just a little bit of minor connection issues, because that'd be real sad, because Chain Reaction has done a great job tonight. I mean, they definitely look like the dominant team, and if you kind of lose your medic to connection issues, that could be really rough.
Absolutely, but I think ZFX and this crits is really the... Stroke of brilliance, because this is saving them right now. The sentry gun has gone down again, but they're still holding on to this point. This cart is so close to the second point right now, but they still have a chance, and they back up to crits again. Turns so fast, so awesome for the last bosses right now. See
and
how
you
they
see,
push.
Boom combo actually is hiding up here in this like apartment region that at least we call it, and they've got their demo, their medic, and their heavy all up here. So if Red knows about this, they can use crits. It's a very confined space. Now the blue heavy drops down onto the cart. It's going to get blasted away, but I think they're going to actually get this capped, and that could be the game if they do. Red spy! Oh, can't block it. So a nice play actually there from Chain Reaction. They didn't even need the Uber. They just kind of dropped their players down on top of the cart, and Red didn't have anybody standing on it, so they just pushed it that last little bit forward.
Yeah, and I've got to point out one of the ballsiest engineers plays I've ever seen. Spamfest built a level 3 wrangled sentry gun in behind the last boss's defense on offense. It was amazing. Hope the people in stream caught that, because that was ridiculously silly, but very, very awesome.
It's part of the trouble with Highlander is camera work with 18 players can just be brutal.
Yeah, and I apologize to everyone watching for my terrible camera work. Usually we have Sud and his HD awesomeness on camera, but you're stuck with the jerky 480p of Kip right now, so apologize about that. But definitely join us next week on Sud, and I will hopefully be back bringing you more Highlander awesomeness. In the meantime, any last thoughts about this game, Yellowstone?
Just a really impressive match from Chain Reaction. You can tell they were well prepared for this map. They had all of their defense set up. They had their players covering all of the entrances. They did just a fantastic job. I mean, the DM didn't even have a chance to come out. If there was a DM advantage for the last bosses, it didn't show, because Chain Reaction was just so well prepared.
Absolutely, and maybe this will be a lesson to the last bosses. DM is just not going to win these games for you. Next week is Granary, which maybe DM could factor in there.
I think it's right in the middle. I mean, if you look at, like, you know, Koth and CTF are really the most DM-heavy maps, and Payload maybe the least. I'd say 5CP is probably somewhere in the middle, but Granary is a map that everyone knows. This isn't something like Swiftwater where you could legitimately say you've never played it. Everyone has played Granary, so that should really help the last bosses. They should all be familiar with this map. They should have all played it, you know, numerous times.
All right, and I've got a special treat for you. Will you welcome into the studio booth Crow and Psydeer. Hey guys, what's up?
Hey, how's it going?
How's it going, everybody?
Why don't you say a little bit about the match from your perspective, Crow? We'll hear from the losers first.
They're a pretty good team, to say the least. Paragon, Jesus Christ. Like, honestly, I want a demo of him just so I can watch it and be amazed. Like, that was incredible. I have never, ever felt like our entire team was pressed down by one player more in my entire life. We could not turn a corner without him wiping us. It was ridiculous. Well played, sir. Well played.
Like I said in the match, we can give you that demo for $5.
Oh my gosh, guys. All right, so...
Because it's UGC rules.
No, but that was really impressive. I'm not gonna lie. That sniper just shit on our team.
Crow, what was your team's impression when Chain Reaction came out with 4 minute and 42 seconds cap time in the first round?
On the first round, to be completely honest, we weren't too worried about it because I don't know if ZFX was having some issues, and we kind of assumed that was the problem. He dropped. Apparently, he was lagging out and he couldn't pop. So I think their demo, I believe, made him drop in the beginning. I don't remember.
Yeah.
And then he said he was having issues. And then, like, a good 2 minutes later, I think he was at, like, 80% or something, he dropped again. So we essentially had to defend without an Uber, I think, for the first 2 points. So we kind of assumed it was that. I'm not going to lie, I think they would have rolled through us regardless. I think we would have posted a lot better at the time, but we couldn't set up anything because we couldn't keep ZFX on the server.
Has he been having connection issues recently, or do you think it was just this server?
I don't want to blame your server, but also, what was up with, could you guys not change loadouts either?
Yeah, we had a period where some of our members couldn't change, and then it would come back, and our heavy crashed during push, so first round wasn't the greatest.
Yeah, well, our soldier, I think, was stuck on direct hit for defense.
Oh.
He was not happy of that. That's why
Kip
he was running
and I,
that. Yeah.
Kip and I thought it was just for lols, because...
No, ZFX wasn't able to switch off of crits. It was a fun ordeal. It was lucky that the only good thing about that is Ropern wanted to play engineer for offense. I was like, sure. So what that actually allowed is that I still was able to make level 3s on defense. If I had played engineer for offense, we would have had Wrangles for level 3 in the second half. Or we would have had we would have mini sentries for level 3. That's the only reason I was able to put up level 3s.
And that's what happened to our engineer. He wasn't able to change on offense, so he was running level 3s on offense the second round.
He sent me a message. He's like, I can't run minis. This game sucks. I'm leaving.
No, it was amazing. Spamfest built a level 3 sentry gun at the very last. It was the ballsiest engineer move I've ever seen, so I appreciated that. Psydeer, while we have you, how did your team approach preparing for this game? Because you guys were obviously really on top of things. How often did you scrim, and what kind of strategy did you use?
We try and scrim anywhere between 5 to 8 times.
Wow.
And you know, if we get some difficult matches, you know, we've been trying to get like the higher level plat scrims. But since we were relatively unknown in the beginning, it was kind of hard to do that. We've been doing STV reviews, watching how we do against other teams and their tactics. And I'm just pretty proud of our team. We're really able to adapt. Based on the other team's play styles. And that's been showing in some of the matches we've been playing.
Absolutely. Yeah, your defense was very coordinated, guys. You could really tell that you had prepared.
And you know, our team, they're really, like, they're wanting to do good. You know, they're always showing up for our scrims. And they're, you know, our comms aren't as good as we would like, but that's something we're working on. But we're always trying new things out, seeing how does this strategy work against this kind of offense or this defense. And I think it showed a little bit in this match.
All right, well, thank you so much for joining us. I think that's probably about all we have the attention span for from our stream viewers. But again, this is Crow and Sidear of The Last Bosses and Chain Reaction, respectively. I'm Kip, and I've been casting with Yellowstone. And thanks so much for joining us, guys. If you want more awesome TF2 action, we still have the Syndicate versus Bonus Points match going on in XTV Esports 2, but it is currently offline. I think they're having some problems with Team Fortress 2. Also, if you're in the mood for some sixes, we have the PUG NA tournament, which I believe is already started on XTV Esports 3. So a lot of stuff going on. Just jump in between channels and you're sure to find some excellent coverage. So that's about it for us here at XTV. Thanks so much for joining us. Be sure to join us next week, 9:30 Eastern time. Going to have another Highlander match for you on Greenery. So thanks so much, guys, and have a good night.